This is McCook's Mr. Bill. It's an honor to have you here. Just taking a little Diet Dr. Pepper break before I hit the afternoon run. Get some kids their quarter snow cones. Had a real good week. I got to donate a whole bunch of free snow cones to the people at McCook Humane Society. They had their fun day, and so I got to help out there. Always like to do things like that. But with the end of September, it's also getting close to Halloween time. I said Halloween time. And a lot of people like to make up scary stories, they do. I have scary stories long before and without any Halloween. Not counting what the federal government, you know, makes us all live in fear. But how about my own Halloween story? Okay. Well, it's not made up, not a lie. And I can't explain it. Maybe you can. I had a family member in the nursing home for 6 years before she passed away. Two doors down from her, another woman lived. And she happened to be outside her apartment in the hallway one day, just sitting there. And so I stopped and visited with her. All too often, people just walk by them like they're zombies or not even there. As I had a nice little visit for a couple of minutes, I went on. Well, that woman got to figuring out when I was going to be coming through, and she would sit at her door hoping to get to visit with me again. Half a dozen times, maybe a dozen times, I visited with her. And never very long, but a nice visit. Nobody ever came to see her, as many in the nursing homes know all too well what that's like. One day, though, she said, I'd like you to come in and look at my family pictures. Okay. So she went in, and I followed her, and there was a big booklet, and she opened it up, and it was her young when she was started working for the government, and then another page or two, she was married, here's wedding pictures of her husband, and they turned a few more, and they had, they'd been to Alaska, they'd been to Mexico, they'd traveled around quite a bit, they seemed to enjoy that, which is fine, many people do. And then she turned another page or two, and there, as she turned the page and just opened it up, the room from that page filled, like it was being filled with a rush of liquid or a rush of cold air. And not just cold, though. Not just cold, evil. And I mean true evil. Never felt anything like it before or since. But the evil was from the floor level as it just whoosh up and filled the room with evil as she turned that page. It was a picture of a young man, maybe late 20s, if I was a guessing man. And within 5 seconds, I felt ill. 10 seconds or better, maybe, give or take, I said, I've got to get out of here. I don't feel good. And I left the room. As soon as I got in the hallway, I was okay. And I closed the door. I was okay. A few days later, when I came back around, I happened to go up and see the manager of the nursing home, get some paperwork done for my relative. And I mentioned to her what I'd run into. And I said, maybe I'm going nuts. And she said, well, maybe not. She said, you know her son. I said, no, I don't. She said, well, he was a convicted pedophile, and he had raped numerous children, they don't know how many, but he was finally caught raping a four-year-old. A four-year-old girl was raped by him. He lived into his early 30s, she said, and she said he was truly a monster, truly a monster. So can some type of evil stay around and be just within the picture that when shown to the public or anyone, that entity might be able to come through? I don't know. But it was the spookiest thing I think I've ever seen, from just a photograph, fear type thing, and pure hate and coldness. Again, I'd never seen it before or since. So I advise you to keep that in mind. And of course, I ask everybody all the time, watch your children, protect your children, and trust no one completely. Rate this film.